And we're back at it again, man. Hey, man. You know, been a while since, you know, last time I see y'all. You know, you see my hair grown a little bit properly. You know, right now we about to go to Orlando. My homies from Orlando, they want me to model their brand called Mxrkt. So we about to drive up to Orlando and make it do what it do. I never really drove. I know y'all seen me go to from LA to Fresno, but I've really never traveled, like, you know, alone in Florida, you know, and I stay out here. I'm like, bro, I'm not, Florida a big state, so it's like, I'm not trying to do all that. I mean, I've been doing that all my life with family, but I never really drove outside of Miami or Palm Beach or whatever the case may be. So this is something new. So yeah, I'm about to enjoy this road trip, man. Come join the vibe with me. it's gonna be a dope shoot. I feel like it's something new. You know, I don't really model, but most people, you know, they'll tell me, oh, Aaron, I want you to just model my clothes or whatever the case may be, or let me photograph you. You know, I'm like, I'm all for it, you know what I'm saying? Like, it's something maybe eventually I'll probably have a career of it, you know, a little small career behind it, but let's see. I'm hyped, I'm stoked about the shoot. So, you know, those are the homies, so we're gonna make it do what it do, man. I'm about to get on this road. I'm actually late, man. I actually forgot a couple things because I ended up just going to a homie spot, just a crash at. So I would just be up the road, but I'm like, dog, I forgot my fucking mouthwash, my toothbrush, my lotion, deodorant. So I had to come back in the morning to get all that shit back home in Miami. And then now I'm on my way up there. So moving backwards, you know, and nigga probably was getting too excited last night, so so but yeah, we gonna enjoy this trip. So we're gonna make it do what it do. Yeah, man, this is actually a good cruise. You know, listening to some Sade, we big vibe. You know, therapeutic trip to me, honestly, you know. But yeah. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
Got the homies. Yeah. I introduce y'all something, man. Don't be tight. Don't be tight.
It's Ed, creative director, Diego, you know, production,
and Bobby, photographer.
Yes, sir. You yes, know sir. What I'm saying? You know, I had to drive up to Orlando. You know, this is their newest collection. You know what I'm saying? Very good quality. We big vibing. Look at that Benz. You know, I know y'all see that. Got the phone in on. Oh man, I miss these seats too, dog. You got me reminiscing. This man got a whole phone. So you did the steering wheel as well too, huh?
The steering wheel. I actually that phone took me like 4 months to get.
Oh wow.
That's straight from Germany.
Yeah.
That's a factory option.
How much you pay for that?
It was like $100.
Okay.
But I got it from a junkyard because they don't make this shit anymore. Anything that I get is is from the Ricardo seats.
I was just about to ask you, because I was about to say Ricardo seats, but, you know, I don't know too much about the leather, but...
Because they were, I don't know if you remember the old one, the seats were, like, straight. Like, they had that pattern that was just
lines. Yeah, yeah.
This shit has the perforated leather.
Yeah. Jeez. Yeah, I can't wait to model in this shit. Got the sunroof. Damn, so what? So this come from, this came from Germany as well too?
Nah, this one I went, bro, I drove to Jacksonville.
Oh wow.
To get this.
And how much was it, like 100 something?
Yeah, this was 200. And this was off of a newer Mercedes.
Oh wow. Like in the 90s type shit?
Yeah. So I'ma upgrade the grill. There goes you.
Okay. Then he got the Lexus too. So they got me rocking. Hey, shit. We big bottom. Look at the bottom. Okay, Uncle Aaron. You got the Reeves, the big keys. We in the game.
Yo, Rockin, what's up? Yo, I'm doing the knowledge, E, man. I'm trying to get paid in full. Well, check this out. Since Norby Walters is our agency, right?
True.
Carol Lewis is our agent.
Word up.
Zakiya and Forth and Broadway is our record company.
Indeed.
Okay, so who we rolling with then?
We rolling with Rush,
our Rush Town Management. So check this out. Since we talking over this deaf beat right here that I put together, I want to hear some of them deaf rhymes. You know what I'm saying? And together, we can get paid in full.
Thank you, Master Plan.
Thinking of a master plan. This ain't nothing but sweat inside my hands. So I think.
I just did a photo shoot the other day on the website, so this is the perfect time. Yo, is this a fisheye lens? Bro, this shit is crazy.
That's a clone.
Wrapped up the shoot with my boy. He just got in the car. You enjoyed the shots, boy?
Yes, sir. That shit was classic. Just like this whip.
Oh, God. You know what I'm saying? We up north with it, man.
Any one time,
you know.
They got it
so clean, dog. She's so clean. For the one time, huh? They got me driving this shit, man. Guinea, dog. They got me driving this shit.
You gotta get it.
He gonna be shooting me and shit.
He got the phone out the window.
Yo. So we just wrapped up the shoot. You know, we just finished eating everything. It's like 5 o'clock right now, 5:30. So I'm about to pull up with my homie Ace before I slide back to Miami to make a do what it do. Another homie of mine that got a clothing brand out here in Orlando. And yeah, we're gonna make a do what it do and pull up on him, man. It was a good shoot, man. It's always good seeing the homies. You know, we was like big vibing, you know. I was on my Geechee shit. So I just had to pull up and, you know, rekindle with the homies. And then, yeah, dog. But, you know, it's just, this trip is, you know, a low-key inspiration. You know, just even me cruising through or in the car, in his car, you know. And that shit brings me back memories because my grandma had a 400E E-Class Benz 1993. And that shit alone was just, like, crazy, man. I don't know, but it's like me bringing Miami to Orlando, you feel me? So, but yeah, right now we about to visit my homie Ace.
I'm doing my vlog shit. She fucked up.
They kicking them out. They look like they kicking their asses out.
The homies got me out, man. You know, I'm Mr. Fuck going out. These niggas got me out, man.
Right? You see the starter jacket? Look what that dude.
Oh,
did.
Shit. Yeah.
Put the label on that shit. Fuck it.
Motherfuckers gonna fuck with that shit.
Off top. Now, I gotta give you something before you see where XL?
Yeah.
I gotta give you something before you go, bro. Nah, I fuck with you. I like what's hype.
Nah,
you
we definitely gonna connect. Like when I come back, like out here, like this shit got me inspired, dog.
This is an extra large right here. It's
for you. I appreciate it.
Nah, I'm top, bro. I fuck with you, bro. You know what it is. Yeah. My boy BAGGG. You know what it is. You feel me? Skrr, skrr. Fuck with you, bro. Off top.
Yeah, so you got. Yo. Another day in the making, you know what I'm saying? We in the month of May right now. Right now I'm on my way to Boston. I got invited to go to a Basquiat show, so I'm gonna be big vibing. You know, I'm very excited. I've never been to Boston, so it's very interesting. I really don't like Boston teams, so I never really care for going to Boston. I hate the Red Sox, I hate the Patriots, I hate fucking Celtics, all that shit in the third. So it's like, you know, that this stuff probably like the only time I'm gonna go to Boston. So you know, I just packed up my luggage, so we gonna be traveling again. Another episode of me traveling. So y'all already know how I am when I travel already. Me going to LA and shit, but Yeah, today's gonna be interesting. You know, this whole weekend gonna be interesting. It's gonna be, you know, my homegirl, she's gonna really treat me out there, you know what I'm saying? And yo, so I'm back from running these errands. So right now, I was gonna wear what I'm wearing right now, but I decided I'm gonna just change for a minute. I'm about to eat real quick because I got a flight in a couple hours. And y'all know how I feel about TSA. TSA is, so we're going to head to the airport, MIA, about to call the Uber after I eat and change. And yeah, man, y'all check this out, man. Shout out to the homies from Bricks and Woods. Shout out to Casey. Got some new sunglasses. I go check them out, man. You know, we got the sticker too, but oh, there you go. Stickers right there. You know, y'all go check them out. Bricks and Woods, man. Oh, I'm gonna give y'all an exclusive real quick. You know, a little Bars bag. You know what I'm saying? You know, a little sneak peek for the summer. You know, light work, you know. So, all right. Let me eat this sandwich and then we back to the airport. Hello, how you doing?
What airline?
JetBlue.
JetBlue, okay.
So I missed my flight. Right now I'm in TSA. I had a busy, you know, this is my first time missing the flight. So now it's time to wait in this line. I wasn't gonna make it anyway. I was rushing the lady and everything. So I'm about to make it do what it do and try to, you know, get to this second flight. We got booked up like to like the second option to Boston. So now, instead of going at 1:30, I'm gonna be there for like 2, I think she said 3 o'clock.
Well, the boarding's 2:45, so that's good. Ain't no pressure. You know, just a little bit later. They said I was gonna get there at 6. I was gonna be at the spot around 6 anyway, so I'll make it do what it do. TSA. See, this is what I be talking about. I don't like TSA, bro. Alright, where is my E20? E20. But yeah, this is why I hate TSA, man. But it's not kind of my fault, though. You know, because I was like running errands and everything. So, yeah, I was too busy doing that. So now, I gotta take that L. But you know, we in a game with it, you know. We made it do what it do. Good thing they rescheduled my flight, so. But, you know, TSA, I gotta stop flying MIA. I gotta start flying Fort Lauderdale and shit. But yeah, we in a game with it, dog. We making it do what it do. And I'm trying to find my flight. E20. Get my bags. I'm gonna make it do what it do. Bye bye. know y'all see the neck rest. I had to get one from TJ Maxx. But we big vibing. About to get my bags and then head to my homegirl's house and vibe. It was a smooth flight. You know, the beginning part of it was kind of rocky. The plane go down, it's just like, yo, what the hell? She done fucked around and cooked for me, man. This how Boston treating me? That's how Boston treating her, man. They gonna make it do what it do. But yeah, man. I'm here, Boston. It's cool, you know. You know, Miami nigga, you know. Boston, you know. I ain't gonna lie, the only thing I'm excited for is this Basquiat vibe and other things that I got planned for Boston, but other than that, the city ain't really, it's cold. It's cool. But, what else, what's the plan, Chef?
For today?
Or today, tomorrow, we in your city, man.
Say my city, but... We are going to the show at 4.
Yes, son, y'all. You baby, look, I ain't put that in the vlog.
Great. What
the fuck
are you doing? I was about to eat without you, actually.
But nah, so yeah, what we doing? What we doing? Like, for today is we chilling, but like, what's tomorrow? Like, what's the, what, Basquiat? Oh, yeah, but then we doing yoga and shit.
Yeah.
Oh, you got
it's still something. Don't worry about it.
No, but go ahead though.
It's a wellness.
But yeah, you know, we going to the Basquiat show, and then I'm doing yoga, man. We big vibing, man. I never done yoga. What made you choose yoga?
It's massage, but it's kind of yoga. Dinner. If you want to go to the morning class.
Yeah, man. I don't really hear her. But yeah, I guess it's recording. But you doing yoga, y'all. So yeah, what are we doing? Yoga?
Getting massages at Wellness Center. They also do yoga classes. So
okay.
You want to get it Sunday morning? Yeah, get really
down. Shit, I think by Sunday. I mean, tomorrow's chilling.
Yeah.
But then I think Sunday would be like, yeah, whatever. We'll figure it out. Damn, man.
You got the aquarium on Sunday.
So yeah. So what you end up cooking? Show people what you dished out for us, man.
Brown rice and quinoa.
You gotta point at it, man.
Brown rice and quinoa salad.
I'm being difficult, man. I'm a difficult friend.
Exactly. Broccoli, peppers, onions, stir fry, and some grilled chicken with a lemon garlic pepper sauce.
Tell them how.
We about to order something.
Yeah.
You told me I had 20 minutes. Like,
yeah.
It ain't even take.
Man, she said she was gonna. She said she was going to get me right. Because you know me, man. I'm off the flight. I'm ready to eat. I pulled up. Ain't ready, man. But, you know. We here now. Which one is my plate?
Which one looks like
your plate? I don't know. All
right. You want some water?
Yeah. Hey, we're gonna be big vibing today, man. I'm gonna be going to this yoga spot, get a massage and shit. Never really did yoga and got a massage and shit, so it's something new. Yeah, I'm just waking up, about to do that, get something to eat right now, take a shower, and then later on, it's going to be the Basquiat exhibit. That's like towards the evening time. So I'm probably going to really be exploring the city and see what Boston got, you know, or whatever. I really want to go to, what's that spot called? Bodega. You know, they had a pop-up in Miami a couple years ago in Art Basel. And I was very, very amazed by it. So I want to see how the original store is. And then somebody also told me, one of my classmates told me, go to Concept, see what they got. Or just, you know, just to see. I ain't probably ain't gonna buy nothing. Cause, hey man, look, got a whole bunch of, I can't even barely fit anything in this damn luggage. Like, I bought a North Face. This was really holding me up for, you know, my, luggage, the damn jacket. You know, I'm a Miami nigga, man. Miami nigga, dog. You know, everything's cold to me. You know what I'm saying? So, it's like, you better be safe than sorry. I've been in some cold places like St. Louis, and that shit was dumb cold. And I regret not really being overly prepared for not wearing a jacket. So, but yeah. So, you know, we big vibing. But yeah, man, you see the Cuban, you know, I had to bring Miami to Boston. You know, we big vibing. But I'm about to take this shower, y'all. And we gonna make it do what it do. I'll see y'all at the yoga spot. We in Boston.
I love the house. It's like, the house is like up north. Like, it's like kind of different, man. It kind of reminds me, mixture of like the Midwest. The Midwest and like the northern part of the states, you know what I'm saying? Even New York, like when you go like outside the city, like the homes are like kind of different, you know what I'm saying? Like three-story homes, but some of these be like apartments and stuff like that. So this is a different vibe up north, man.
This girl would get the city girls. Shit, crazy.
You could leave a Miami girl. You could take a Miami girl out. She's still gonna be a Miami girl. I don't even know if that makes sense, but y'all know what I mean.
Staying with it, okay. So we late because of Troy. You know what I'm saying? No, we about to go to this yoga shit. Oh, they bringing Miami to Boston for real. Let me take a video. They done fucked around from Miami to Boston, or Broward rather. So I'm about to just get into the massage vibes. You know, I'm about to get right. Just ended the spa. You know, it was very, very good, man. I needed that. But I'm gonna start getting massages more often because, yeah, it's a whole vibe. I'm gonna have to go to my homegirl Rose spot, you know, back home in Miami, and I can do what I do. But this spot that we at, this is a black owned yoga and massage parlor. You know what I'm saying? So if you're in Boston, go make sure you go to Four Corners and support the black businesses out here, or black business out here. It's something different because I never really know would have known if it's like a black yoga and massage parlor, you know, ever. You know what I'm saying? So this is dope that it's out here in Boston.
this from the girl. Late because of Troy, man. Nah, she's still getting ready. Yeah. Anyway, we about to go to what's called again?
MFA.
And look at the Basquiat exhibit. And yeah, I'm excited, man. You know, Basquiat's one of my favorite artists. Just to really see his work. Person live in action. It's gonna be interesting, man. Hopefully they let us film and then with anything I'll take pictures and everything, but we're gonna make it do what it do from there. Telling me like to get around the city, you had to really go through the residential areas. So that was very interesting. You can't even go to like the expressway to get to your destination. So that was interesting. You know, in Miami, we usually take the interstate just to get to point A to point B. But that was very interesting. You had to go through the neighborhoods, go through downtown, and everything like that. She's just taking selfies and shit. You can't take black people nowhere. But yeah, man, shit wild. Shit wild seeing it in person. So crazy, I met 5'5 Freddy and Art Basel like 3 years ago. And but people don't know, 5'5 Freddy was best friends with Basquiat and stuff like that. So it's interesting to see certain stuff that 5'5 Freddy is included in this exhibit. Doors to the Basquiat. It's like a lot of Keith Haring, Basquiat, 5'5 Freddy work. So that's pretty dope and tight. And like, And like, this is like all the stuff that, you know, people that Basquiat collaborated with as well. Crazy, cause I'd be on my 80s shit too. I'd be dressing like I'm in the 80s. Like what I'm wearing right now is really on some 80s shit. I've seen stuff like this before, but like every time I do see it in person, it makes you think. Wow.
Just finished going to the museum, and now we about to go to Bodega, which is a shoe store. And perfect timing. So we just left the museum. Right now we about to go to Bodega. Bought me a couple books, and yeah, man, then get something to eat. I'm hungry. So, about to make it do what it do. It was a nice show. Even though this girl was taking selfies throughout, she enjoyed herself. She was just too busy taking the selfies and shit. You enjoy yourself, though?
I did. And these are also lies. I was reading the descriptions of the art.
I ain't lying. She probably was proof reading. She was skim throwing that shit. But what you learned from it, though?
I think one of the pieces where the artist actually wanted his...
Which artist? Basquiat?
No, it was Romilly's, I think, something like that. He wanted his ashes included into his artwork.
Oh, wait, you talking about...
It was one of his, the people he was painting with at the time. And he made, like, this sculpture with graffiti on it, and it was like a pyramid. And he wanted his ashes in the pyramid and for it to be shown. So I think that was dope.
Me, I just thought about, you know, shit, you know, I'm an artist, so seeing fucking Basquiat, that's one of my favorite artists. So that shit just, that shit.
Huge.
Yeah.
I couldn't imagine that.
But it's like, I know she like, oh, what the fuck? But no, it's like, you know, it's like, damn, Basquiat really did those. Like,
yeah,
that's his
legacy.
Yeah,
that's what
legacy.
I was thinking, too. I was like, this man really painted that. Like, we're looking at something that he touched and he was creating, and, like, the group of people that he chose to create it with.
Right.
And because it was shit like refrigerator doors and window panes and shit in there. Like, just the fact that they did it, like, that they touched it, made it what it is. And I think, like, that's what makes art immortal.
Right. And it's just like, for me, it's just like, Being an artist, a creative, it's like prophecy or some shit like that. Cause you like leaving a legacy.
Yeah.
Like when you gone, dead and gone, it's like you have something you have in this earth to keep on your name alive and shit like that. So that was very interesting.
And black art matters.
Oh yeah, we gotta use that. We gotta copyright that.
No, cause it's a whole Basquiat auction where they're auctioning off a Basquiat painting, but the person who wins the auction gets to destroy the piece if they want to.
I ain't destroying no Basquiat shit.
No, that's the whole point. They don't do that to like white artists.
Where
like, oh, you could destroy this Picasso if you want to. Like, no, like,
no, that shit works.
That's not like one of the things they introduce as, oh, it's like as an option when you buy art.
Mm-hmm.
The whole point is it's supposed to last forever.
Yeah, I actually I was literally in there and I was just like, yo, I gotta get a Basquiat in a crib, man. Yeah, you know, it's Basquiat, you know, it's in there, you know, it's nothing new. But nah, man, we about to get something to eat, man, or we about to go to Bodega before it closes and Concept probably, depending on how I feel. And then that's pretty much it for the day. You know, it was a good little vibe. You know, coming from Miami, going to Boston, and seeing something different. I actually get invited to the Basquiat show, I want to say thank you. Thank you, Troy. You know what I'm saying? You know? So,
but yeah. Supposed to take that train.
We ain't taking no goddamn train. Fuck that. We not in New York. Probably, nah. We not. Nah, I ain't taking no train.
He's like, I'm straight.
Probably like to get something to eat. Probably, but we'll get. All right, y'all. We better go to Bodega. I ain't gonna be here too long, so I'ma fuck with y'all and catch y'all later. So right now we got koi sai. It's a mixture of curry. They got curry sauce, so it's like a ramen mixed with like chicken and stuff like that. So we're about to tell this thing up. Look at Troy. She already fucking up shit. What you got? She don't even know. You can't take nobody nowhere, man. Look at her. Look at her. She tear that thing up, boy. It's good. It's good. Yeah, man. I'm about to tear this thing up, though, man. I'll holler at you when I'm done with. What is up, y'all? You know, we had a good day yesterday at the museum, at the MFA. Today, we about to just, me and Troy about to go to the aquarium and then just call it a day. Tomorrow, go back to Miami. And get a few things going on, back to school, and then also, what else I got going? Yeah, you know, just getting worked on finalizing a couple things as far as schoolwork, you know, stuff for FGO and things for Bodge, and yeah, man, that's pretty much it. You know, it was an interesting trip, you know, vibing with Troy. And, you know, actually get to see Basquiat's work is very, like I said before, it hit different in person. you know, back home in Miami. And that's really it, man. You know, Boston, you know, y'all had a little something for me. Selfies and shit?
Of course.
I don't know as y'all girls in the selfie shit, but you know. So we gotta wait 10 more minutes just to you know, go in the aquarium because of an appointment. So yeah, because she got dressed too early and shit, so
we got dress me,
you know what I'm saying? But we in the game with it. We in the game, but big vibe, man. You know, it's my last day. I can't wait to get back to Miami. Boston, y'all cool, but you know, y'all ain't like Miami. Damn. Where you at, man?
You like what you
say? Nah, man, but you know, I miss Miami, man.
Take me back.
Take me back. You know, Boston, you know, it's a little rival, you know. That's why, you know, I really didn't think I would ever come to Boston. I would never think I would have come to Boston. That's the last place on my mind. Last place on my mind. But we big vibing with it, dog. If I ain't think it was so cultural, it'll be a cultural place and shit.
Yeah, a lot of Hispanic people, a lot of Chinese people too.
Yeah, you gotta.
They've seen titties before. Sure of it. How they got here? Hey, mamas.
Oh, yeah, today. I forgot. Today's Mother's Day, y'all. Happy Mother's Day to everybody. I know y'all probably won't get this video to like later in May. But yeah, happy Mother's Day to everybody. Y'all go check out Rod's episode of, you know, Miss Mama Davis. You know. So yeah, man. You know, my fit too looking too crazy. You got, hold on, you gotta get the fit. Let motherfucker see the fit.
I can't see you?
Oh yeah, you gotta motherfucker see the fit, you know?
Let him know.
You got the reeds.
Mm-hmm.
You know what I'm saying? Miami nigga in Boston, you heard me. you know, we bringing Miami to Boston. Let niggas know how we doing it everywhere else, you know what I'm saying? You know, but New York next week, very excited, getting business done, interviews done. I know I've been slow this season for season four, but you know, no rush, man. You know I do 50 million things in one time, and y'all just getting to see the things that I do, you know, constantly and everything. So you know, in New York, I'm gonna be interviewing a jeweler, one of the homegirls that does jewelry, illustrator. Who else? Maybe do a couple shoots out there while I'm over there and link up with homies. So. I don't see nothing too crazy so far. So we just left the aquarium. That shit was.
He wasn't satisfied.
Nigga, that shit was. Man, I'm like, that's it? That shit crazy, man. But you know, I seen fishes in there. I'm like, bro, we live in Miami, dog. We see that shit all the time. It ain't nothing new, dog.
He did like a big ass turtle, though. He couldn't find it again.
Yeah, it was a big ass turtle, but. Nigga, you see that shit all the time. Boston, I'm not impressed, man. not impressed. I'm not downplaying y'all city, but damn, man. It's the, again, it's the rival. It's the Miami rival, man. But that's really it, man, for my last day in Boston. I'm about to just eat what I had yesterday and call it a motherfucking day. She was going to get some tacos. I'm like, bro, it ain't that deep. You got food from yesterday.
It is that deep. I'm actually about to still get them. You know what I'm talking about.
Bro, that shit crazy. So what, we about to call the Uber?
Mm-hmm. You want to get it real quick? Yeah. Or are you going to walk?
We can sit.
But I still love the idea. There's plenty to eat.
Yes.
In fact, they've asked me to write their slogan. There's plenty to eat.
Yo. Last day, well, this is the last day of me being in Boston, so I'm about to head back to Miami. It was a great trip. You know, Boston, you know, something to get used to. Not used to this type of city, but I love the how everything's kind of like, it reminds me of like the Midwest, you know what I'm saying? But it's like the northern part of the Americas, whatever the case may be. So it was kind of good, you know, just kind of like a refresher, you know, just to get my mind right, just get inspired, just to see Basquiat work. So, you know, one of my favorite artists. So it's just like, you know, just seeing this, you know, good shit of the city, you know what I'm saying? Learn a lot about Boston, you know, on how the people are, the culture and stuff like that, through the locals and stuff like that. So now it's time to go back home. Thank God. Got a busy week, and then I gotta go fly back to New York and make it do what it do and link up with friends. New episodes of Behind the Beard. That's it. You know, really doing that. So I see y'all back in Miami, and it's gonna be good to be home. So let's get it.